Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from a disgusting day in Toronto. It is sleet outside. I see white stuff coming down. This does not make me happy. It is a stormy day, and I'm glad I'm inside. Definitely glad I'm inside. I have been simultaneously recording Vlogmas. I've done a little bit of the setup and a chat, and now I'm just about to start the podcast. So it is going to be a very, very busy day. So I've got lots to share. This is going to be a chock-a-block, full-on way to end the podcast year podcast. I have everything. I've got spoiler alerts. I've got finished objects. I've got secret knits. Lots and lots of goodies to share with you. Lots of brown paper packages as well. So nice surprises to get us through this stormy December 1st. So welcome to the podcast. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you are new, welcome. This is a podcast that is primarily about knitting, and today it's mostly about the knitting. And I chatter away about things that I've made, things that I'm dreaming of making, things like that. So welcome. Grab a seat, grab a warm or cold beverage, whichever your locale calls for, and have a chance to just sit down and relax as I chatter on about the makes that I've been up to this week. If you are a returning viewer, welcome back. This is the last podcast of 2019. I will be doing Vlogmas, though I am sort of questioning my sanity on that one. I've got a very, very hectic week ahead. I'm a little bit nervous about how I'm going to manage it all, but it will be fun trying. Anyway, I have a chock-a-block episode for you, and I hope that you are all snuggled down, warm. I didn't put the fireplace on. I need to put the fireplace on when I have a break. You've got your beverage of choice. You've got your project of choice. You've got your comfy spot on the couch, and you are ready to start chattering about the things that I am going to share with you. So let's get started with some tea time. And today I am drinking out of my Julia Smith Christmas puppy mug, and I have made some tea in my stump teapot. So let's pour that now. It's a little bit weak still. Oh, it's getting a little bit stronger. It'll steep a little bit longer for the second cup. And there is my cup of tea ready. But before I say cheers to anything, I'm going to tell you what I'm drinking today. Because it is December 1st, I'm feeling a little bit Christmassy. I have opened Advents on the Vlogmas episode 1, already recorded. Just need to do a few other things. But my tea today is Bird and Blend, and this is some stash from last year. This is Christmas cake. So I'm starting off December right with Christmas cake and Christmas puppy mug, and we are ready to go. So I am wishing you a wonderful December ahead, filled with lots of happy memories, lots of family time, and hopefully lots of sanity. And I'm sort of, as I said, I'm questioning mine right now. So anyway, cheers to wonderful memories in December 2019. Yum, 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 yum. Just a nice, perfect amount of spice. I'm a little nervous that the second cup might be a little bit overpowering, but I can always add a little bit of hot water if I need to. But yes, my Christmas puppy and I, a little bit of caffeine, and then we're ready to move on. I just popped the fireplace on, so in a few minutes it will be nice and toasty warm in here, which will make me very, very happy. In the meantime, I am excited to share with you some of the things that I've been up to, including 4 finished objects this week. And I have a couple of test knits that I'm still working on that I have a little bit that I can share of each of those. So they are going to keep me very busy this week, especially with Vlogmas happening. But I'm very, very excited to be working on both of those. But for now, I am going to start off with the finished objects. Usually I do it the other way around, but today I'm going to turn things over a little bit. Are you going to come up, Tasha? Tasha, the cat, is just eyeing the couch and she's debating coming up. But maybe once she sees the knits, she'll definitely want to come up. The past few weeks, I have been working on KnitVent, and the last two patterns were released this past Thursday. And the last two patterns were living in this project bag. I used the same yarn for both of those projects. And that yarn was Slate on DK, and this is Nora George Yarns, and it's a beautiful gray. This is the same yarn that I am using to knit my Gathering Driftwood wrap with that I'm still not finished. That's going to be a late December project, early January. I do plan to finish it before the winter is out because it will be a beautiful wrap and a very classic wrap to be able to wear, but there's so many cables and it just requires a lot of energy. So I think once I'm on holiday, this will be a perfect knit to work on. But in the meantime, I have some other things made from this gorgeous yarn. And that had been in my Luli bag. This is my Nutcracker Sweet bag. And that had been a gift to me from Helen as a thank you for all of the test knitting and as a Merry Christmas last year. So the first thing I'm going to share with you are the Home Body Mitts. And these are fingerless mitts. And they are definitely comfy cozy because they are knit out of the DK. And these are going to be a gift for somebody. I have a friend who absolutely loves wrist warmers and she's always cold. Her hands are always cold. So as soon as I saw these and I knew I was going to be knitting them in here, I've been planning to make her something like this for a couple of years and these will be going to her, so I'll need to take them to work with me, and when I see her next, they will be gifted. But they are lovely, squishy. They have a 3x1 ribbing at the fingertips and also at the wrist area, and then there is this lovely patterning that happens, and then there's little thumb openings so that you can do things, type on your phone or your iPad in my case, whatever. But yes, and the pattern goes all the way around, so it's not just flat on the palm. But a very simple mitt to knit, and I knit one day, and I knit the second the next day. So very, very quick knits, and that is a pattern that was released this past Thursday, and these are the Home Body Mitts. And along with the Home Body Mitts is the Home Body Hat. And I have to be honest with you, usually I'm really good and I block my hats. I did not block this hat yet. And there is a little bit of reasoning behind my madness there. I don't know what it is, but I do not wet block hats because when I wet block hats, they go from fitting me to being way too big. I'm not sure why. I usually steam block, and I had popped the pom-pom on, and I didn't want to steam block when I had the pom-pom on. This is also going to be a gift for somebody, and that's somebody I don't think likes pom-pom. So I've actually just tied the pom-pom on with a bow, so I will actually remove it, and then I'll steam it to gift it. But this is the Home Body Hat, and I have a small head. This is the adult small. There is an adult large. I probably, if I want to make this for myself, I think it might be kind of important for me to make the child size because I guess it's good for slouchy. Covers your ears, which is great. Get those little wisps out if I can. Anyway, this is the adult small. I have a small head. So I sort of waver between adult small and child size. And I suppose if I wanted to keep that with the pom-pom, it would be definitely very, very cute. But this is going to be a gift, and I think it will be a good fit for my recipient. But I will be taking the pom-pom off, even though it goes so well with this hat. Because, yeah, I don't think the person I'm giving it to is a huge fan of pom-poms. And if they are, I can always bring it with me and stitch it on properly, and then they'll have a pom-pom on their hat. But an unblocked hat. I know, I'm terrible, Tracy. Anyway, that is project two, and those were the last of the knit bent patterns. So this year I only knit 5 of the 6 patterns. I decided not to make the cushion because I knew that Scout would be all over it, and oh, who wants to be hand washing a cushion that the dog has slobbered all over? So that was the one I didn't do, but all the other ones I think were absolutely brilliant. The throw, the habitation throw, was a great way to use minis, and just a fun collection this year for sure. Tasha, she's not coming up on the couch. She has decided to lie by the fire. That is actually her favorite place. I should have known that was where she was going to go. So if you have a chance to pop over by the fire, give her a little pet. Let us move on to my next finished object. And this is one I started in July. I cast it on Nathaniel's birthday. And we had gone to Disney World very spur of the moment. And that trip was kind of fueled on by something that Jules, who is so sweet Violet, had sent me. And it was just a little video she sent me. And I went from not really wanting to go camping in Cape Cod to spontaneously changing the plans and going to Disney World. And so that is all thanks to Jules. It was a fabulous time. And it meant that I was going to change all of my knitting projects. And because I was going to the world and I was going to be hanging out with Disney princesses, I had some gorgeous yarn from Yarn Inc., which was princess based. And I'll pull that yarn out now. That was the June 2017 mini club. And all of the princesses are represented in a mini. And now all I'm left with are little tiny balls of princess yarn. But they are so, so cute. And I have Cinderella. I have Snow White. I have Ariel, who got knit on poolside. I have Anna from Frozen, and Frozen 2 now too. And then I have Belle from Beauty and the Beast. So these were the 5 princesses, and that had been my Yarn Ink Club. So that was my yarn. The bag that I brought was this fun Winnie the Pooh bag, and that was from Little Skein in the Big Wool. So that went with me to Disney, and I cast on the Winter Bird socks while I was in Disney. And this is a pattern that Jules had designed for Kelly of Lay Family Yarns for her advent kit. So the pattern was released yesterday, and they are crazy socks because I used some crazy yarn, but they were so fun to knit. And I was really looking more at knitting this for the fun factor and using these princess yarns. And this was a test knit that I actually wasn't going to do just because I couldn't fit it in. But then as soon as I changed my plans, I decided I needed to work on these socks in the princess yarn. So they're crazy. So these are the Winter Bird socks, and they've got this lovely textured pattern with them. And I start off the toe because Cinderella and her shoes, they really should always go into the shoe first. So the toe is Cinderella and the cuff is Cinderella. By the way, Cinderella is my favorite Disney princess. In this section here, this is Snow White. And then Ariel is right around the last repeat and into the gusset. These are toe-up socks. And so when I took a photograph poolside, I was right in this section here. And then we have Anna, and then we're going into Belle. And as I said, we top it off with Cinderella. And they are crazy and stripy, but definitely a fun, fun knit. And that texture is just so fun. I love the sample that Jules has made in the blue. She's got the blue toe, and then she's got a white and blue speckled yarn, and she's just done it in one color. She's also done it in soft pinks as a mini set combination. You could do it any number of ways. These are toe up, so they've got Jules' little toe. I'm forgetting the name of the toe. She's a special name for it, beanie toe. And then she has her godet heel. I think that's how you say it, godet, G-A-U-D-E-T. Maybe it's godet, but I go for the French, godet. And it's a really great heel. And then it's got a little bit of an eye of partridge little section here. And then we're back into the winter bird pattern. So definitely a fun knit, a great Advent sock. If you're starting to think about your Christmas Eve cast on, maybe winter birds is the one for you. But oh my goodness, there are so many wonderful socks. So there's the winter birds, plus there's a couple things I've also got here. So I'm glad I'm pre-knitting them, because I would have a very, very difficult time choosing a sock pattern for Christmas Eve cast on. That's why I'm going with mittens this year. The final finished object that I am going to share with you, and I've already popped all of the yarns into a bin. This is the Advent pattern by Tracy, who is the dyer behind Nora George Yarns. And she designed this pattern to go with her Advent kit. Well, I'm just starting to open my Advent kit from Tracy. I've already knit this, so I don't know what I'm going to knit with my Advent kit this year, but maybe another one of these cowls, but I think I'm gonna hold off and see what else comes up, because this is a gorgeous cowl and I'm really, really happy with the yarns that I have chosen. So this is the Snowdrift cowl. And the minis that I used were Nora George Yarns mini sets. I used two mini sets, so 10 minis total. You could use this, you could knit this pattern with either 12 or 24, any combination of two. So you just need an even number of minis and you can make it whatever length you would like it to be. So I went with 10 minis. I used a 4mm needle. I would recommend a 3.5 for this pattern, just to make it a little bit more dense. And that's also because I live in Toronto where it's snowing outside right now. So I probably would want more of a warmer cowl. So this is the Snowdrift cowl. And as I said, I used two sets of Christmas minis. I used, and I'll start off with Modern Christmas. So this pink, this white speckle, silver, turquoise, and then a gold. Sounds much nicer than yellow. So that is the Modern Christmas section of the cowl. And then the traditional minis are green, a green speckle, a red, green, and white speckle, red and white speckle, and then a gorgeous red. And then that leads us back into the Modern Christmas. So it is a true Christmas cowl. And this is 10. I would say if you went with 12, so if you have a 12-day mini set, you could probably wrap it comfortably around twice. It's not too bad, actually. It's a little bit tight, but I am able to wrap it around twice. If you used a 24 set, oh my gosh, you could just wrap it around and be all snugly warm with all of those fantastic colors. So this is the length of mine with 10. As I said, I used a 4mm. I would recommend a 3.5, which would mean it wouldn't be as wide, but it would be a little bit more dense, which I think would be good. But look at the gorgeous patterning in there. So there's the two, the drop stitch section and then the slip stitch section. So that has been off my needles for quite some time. And oh, it screams Christmas, doesn't it? It is gorgeous. I absolutely love it done up in the traditional and the modern set. Love, love, love this pattern. Anyway, that is what I have been up to and hiding for quite some time. These have been waiting. Well, I just finished these the other day, but I've known about the pattern for quite some time. But this has been done and waiting for release for quite a while. Those are my finished objects. So let's get to my works in progress. And these are secret knits. I did share a little bit with you last week on this one. And this is my unicorn bag. This is from Southern Sparrow Handmade. And I am using this gorgeous, gorgeous sparkly yarn from Louie and Lola. Look at that glitter on there. Oh my goodness. You're going to see a bit of a theme in my works in progress. I'm feeling very Christmassy and very sparkly. So this is Louie and Lola yarns, and this is part of the Christmas wreath set. I'm not using the red in this pattern. And this pattern is going to be released this upcoming Thursday. And this is the final Sock Society test knit for 2019. So I've got some knitting to do, but oh my goodness, look at that gorgeous, gorgeous green sparkle. So that's what is in here. And I will be able to share this with you later on this week. So I'm very excited about that. But as I said, I've got some knitting to do. I don't know what it is, but green sparkle seems to be exactly what I am needing now. Maybe it's because I want a green Christmas instead of a white one out there. Yes, I keep expressing my displeasure with the weather. So, green sparkle there. In a sparkly bag too. And the next project that I am working on, and it's got a release date just a few days after the Sock Society. I'm not sure of the exact date. It is in my gorgeous Vintage Fairy Lights bag by Little Bobbins. What can that mean? And this bag is absolutely adorable and sparkly. This is the test knit for Danny's Christmas Eve cast-on pattern for 2019. So last year I did the test knit as well, and I used a gorgeous maroony red, which was Viola Yarns. And I also highlighted it, and you're going to love this, with this gorgeous green sparkly yarn. Got something going on here with the green and the sparkle. So this is Louie and Lola, and this is Nora George Yarns. Christmas wreath, fur. It's all about the green trees and the sparkle. So these are, they're similar, but they're different. This is a little bit more mossy, and this is a little bit more bright, traditional Christmas, but I am loving using both of these yarns. It's just so exciting to make these. And while this is not necessarily Christmas themed, it's not Christmas themed at all, it will be a fun one if you decide that you would like to do a Christmas cast on for the Sock Society. But this is going to be Danny's Christmas Eve cast on pattern. I am loving it and having a very, very hard time putting it down. It's very bad to say that I am farther along in this pattern than I am in this one. They're both lovely, but Danny's patterns are addictive. Anyway, I am using fur from Nora George Yarns as my main color, but I'm having fun with this pattern and I'm playing with some yarn. I am also using some undyed sparkle yarn. This is Nora George, her sparkle sock, and it is undyed because I just wanted to have some white. It's got a little, it's funny the way that the light is hitting it. It looks like there's little red streaks, but there aren't. It is an off-white yarn with sparkle. So, main color, contrasting color, but I didn't stop there. I'm really having fun with this pattern. I have added some undyed cloud. This is a Surrey Silk yarn by Tracy of Nora George, and I'm adding a little bit of fluff into these socks. So I'm having a little bit too much fun knitting this pattern, and I am absolutely adoring how it is coming up now. So it's just so hard to put down though. That's the one problem. Anyway, these are my yarns for the Christmas Eve cast on. This is going to be released in December so that when you are trying to figure out what you would like to knit, if you are going to take part in the Christmas Eve cast on, you've got lots and lots of choice. And of course, the Christmas Eve cast on Queen Dani has got a lovely pattern that will be coming out very, very soon. So that is what is in here. Sock Society, also on sparkly yarn, is in here. It's all about the sparkle. So I am going to be very, very busy for the next few days knitting socks. My fingers are going to be quite sore. Yesterday I had a bit of an accident. I was out with my best friend and we were in the drugstore and we were trying to find some nylons or pantyhose, and I ran my finger. I went to grab something and I hit the corner of where they clip on the prices, and it was metal and sharp, and I cut my finger. So not a very good thing to do when you've got two pairs of socks that you are trying to get done very, very quickly. But the green sparkle makes it all good. Anyway, that is all I have to share on my favorite things. It has been a lot, definitely a lot. It's now time for brown paper packages, and I have to tell you, it has been a very, very robust week. My mailman has brought me lots and lots of lovely packages. And I'm going to start off by sharing a gorgeous parcel that came in from Jules, who is So Sweet Violet. And this was a little thank you for doing some test knits this year. There was chocolate. It is gone now. I did not eat the chocolate. I shared the chocolate. I gave it to Nathaniel. But also in that little parcel was a cute little mouse hand bomb with a little tail. And this is orange and cinnamon, smells absolutely glorious. And my little parcel had this adorable little bunny as well. So I think there's going to be some styling at Easter happening. So a huge thank you to Jules for sending that little parcel my way. And just a nice thing to come home to on a late November day when the days are getting darker. The next thing that I received this week, actually I received this Friday, but I'm going to share it now. This is something I purchased last Sunday, so it's amazing that I already have it. It was sent by FedEx, so it came a little bit faster. But last week I was talking about how I'm really horrible at color work. And one of the comments that was left on my YouTube comment section was that I should maybe think about getting myself a ring that I can do some color management with. And this has been something I've been thinking about for a little while, because the lovely Christine has been trying to talk me into buying this gorgeous ring that she bought one, and she says it's a game changer. So I did it. I bought myself a knitting ring, and I'll put all of the details of where I got it from, because at this point, I'm having difficulty reading the script. So this is the beautiful box it came in. And I ordered large, but I think maybe I should have ordered medium. It is a little bit adjustable. So this is a sterling silver ring that I can pop on my finger because I do continental knitting. And you can put your strands of yarn in there. And I have tightened it up a little bit here. So I did get large, and it does have that sort of adjustable bit there, which allows you to then tighten it on your finger. I've tried it a little bit. The reason I was really contemplating it is because I get really bad yarn burn on my finger, especially when I'm knitting socks, because I have to tension so tightly. So I'm hoping that this will help with getting rid of that yarn burn. And once I sort of try and focus on doing some color work, maybe I'll be able to use some of these other little divots here to help me figure out yarn management and do some color work a little bit better than my weird throwing that was happening before. So that is my sterling silver ring, and I'll put the details of who it's from, just because off the top of my head I can't remember and I want to go on with the flow. But it's really well made. It is lovely. It came in less than a week in this beautiful little presentation box. And I could not wait till Christmas to open it. So I told my husband, I'm buying myself a ring. So I bought myself a ring. Didn't have diamonds, so it wasn't too crazy. But it is sterling silver, so a bit of an investment, but should be something that will last. So getting used to it, it's a little bit strange having the ring and standing up and doing the changing of when I change sides, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. So that's one thing that arrived this week, or that's now two things that arrived. The final things that I am going to share on this final podcast of 2019 are Nora George yarns. So very fitting, because if you have tuned in previously, you know I love my Nora George yarns. So I've got some vintage Nora George, I've got some spoiler alerts, I've got some other little goodies that Tracy has sent my way as well. So let's get started with the Nora George segment of the podcast. And I'm going to start off with some vintage Nora George yarns. And this is a skein of yarn that I was able to pick up on Tracy's D-Stash. And it is using her gorgeous former logo, which this is my favorite of her logos. I just love this one. And this is a Mrs. Weasley's Knit Club from the first round, and it is Madame Malkin's Robes for All Occasions. And as soon as I saw this, I had to ask, and oh my goodness, love, love, love. There were a couple other ones there that I would have loved to have been able to get, but I was not able to, and I definitely wanted a lot of the old vintage ones. I do have some of the earlier Mrs. Weasley's Knit Clubs, but I have two from the first round from Diagon Alley, and then I started getting into the Mrs. Weasley's Knit Club a little bit later, so it's nice to have some of those original ones. So some vintage Nora George came in my mail this week. The next thing I am going to share with you, and we're going into spoiler alert, from here on out, everything I have to share is spoiler alert. So I am going to share the Sweater Club for the winter of 2019. It was a four round club, and I had to choose between DK and Super Sock. And I do love my Super Sock, and I tend to use it a little bit more than I do DK. So it was a really hard choice, but I ended up going with the Super Sock. And there's going to be some crinkling happening. You don't want to spoil it completely. So if you do not want to see the Sweater Club or the final Mrs. Weasley's special sock club for the year, I think this is actually a special edition, close your eyes, cover your ears, run screaming out of the room, do what you need to do, because I am going to share some gorgeous, gorgeous club yarn with you.
And I'm going to start off with the Shawl Club. So the Shawl Club is three skeins of absolute gorgeousness. And these are all on Super Sock, as I mentioned. And this is the Winter Shawl Club 2019. And there is this gorgeous burgundy Merlot sort of color, a gorgeous teal, and then an amazing speckle. And I think that will make a gorgeous three-color shawl for sure. And I just don't know what pattern at this point I would make. So I may just hold on to these as I wait for future test knits. Or maybe I see something that I think this would go really, really well with. This actually would make, if you wanted to split it up and do a snowdrift cowl, spindrift, that's a totally different shawl. A snowdrift cowl, that's the one that I shared earlier today that I did in the Christmas minis. This would be kind of fun to do like a three section, maybe even going color A, color B, color C, and then back to this. So using more of this than these two, but that would be a fun snowdrift cowl. It's always fun when you start, you get something new in the mail and you start dreaming about what it will become. So that is the Shawl Club Winter for Nora George Yarns 2019. Now I just get to dream about what I will knit. And the final thing that I'm going to share with you, again, we are still in spoiler alert, is the Yule Ball 1999 yarn. And it came with this fun little, and I haven't figured out how to get the chocolate out yet, and there's also a progress keeper that is buried in the snow here. I much prefer the snow in here than the snow out there. But this with the little truffle and a progress keeper came in the package. I need to figure out where to open this so that I don't get little things everywhere, little balls of snow everywhere. And I also got this lip balm. It is a chocolate mint lip balm, and Tracy has been making some aromatherapy products, some candles, lip balms, hand balms, and this is my first try. So I haven't tried it yet. I wanted to save it for the podcast, but my lips have been really, really dry, so I'm looking forward to using that. So there we go. That was what came with Yule Ball 1999, and now it is time for the gorgeous, gorgeous yarn. And here is the main color. It is on Sparkle, so it is definitely glorious. And the mini that came with it is also on Sparkle, and it is this amazing, amazing pink. I love these colors, and I love the fact that it is on Sparkle yarn. So Sparkle Sock, always a good thing. So that was my crazy full mailbox this week. And now I have an empty bag or an empty bin. And that's okay because I have so much yarn that I need to get through that now I've got even more. Anyway, that is Brown Paper Packages, and oh my goodness, I had some lovely things come through the door this week. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And I have to tell you, it has been a full episode this week. This is the way to do a podcast. You know, you've got full of everything. So finished objects, secret knits, lots and lots of packages for Brown Paper Packages. So I think I have done it right for the final episode of 2019. So Bits and Bobs this week, it has been a hectic week. I am going into an even more hectic week. I will be taking on Vlogmas for the month of December. I think I might be a little bit insane to even think about trying to do it, But I'm going to try and do my best. It's going to be a little bit challenging, especially this week. It is going to be a very, very hectic week. Next weekend, we will be going to see Isaac's show in Windsor. So I'm not sure how I'm going to handle Vlogmas for that period of time, because I do like to do my Vlogmases the day of. I may have to do next weekend as a block. But I do have the Monday afterwards off, which will be a lovely chance to just exhale. And then I'm hoping after that, it will be a little less hectic. Yesterday, I went out with my friend. As I said, I hurt my finger, but I also, while I was out, took my sewing machine in for a tune-up. There is a place that is near where she lives that I've been thinking about taking my sewing machine in for a cleaning and a tune-up, and I thought, I will drop it off either on the way there or on the way back. I did it on the way back because it was a little less stressful. Unfortunately, when I was there, I did discover that they will be closing their shop. They're going to retire at the end of January. So I was happy that I got the machine in now so that I got it nice and cleaned up before they do retire. She did pass along the name of the person that they use, so I will have his name. So it's a little bit sad when a shop like that closes, but it is also nice for them to retire. And I asked about if she had any recommendations of places to take quilting lessons, and she said, I don't know, I'm going to probably take some myself, which I thought was interesting that that's what she offered in her place, that she would want to take some continuing quilting classes as well, but that's always a fun thing to do. I was thinking about taking the baby quilting workshop that is going to be at UKnit for the next few weeks, but I thought that was probably taking on one thing too much in addition to KnitVent, the test knits, work, and just all of crazy December. So I did, by taking my machine to get it tuned up, I cannot sign up for this workshop, even though I really, really want to. I had signed up in the summertime, but then they changed the weekend and I wasn't available for one of the weekends. So I thought, I'll sign up another time. So I will sign up another time, not in December when I am trying to do everything, because yes, I might be pleading insanity. Anyway, I think, oh yes, Nathaniel. Nathaniel got a role in their upcoming school musical that they will be doing, and this is the director's last year. He'll be retiring. Isaac had this director all through his elementary school years, and Nathaniel has been enjoying music and joining in the musicals the past few years. This year they're going to be doing Alice in Wonderland. Nathaniel auditioned to be the Cheshire Cat, but actually got the role of the March Hare. So the March Hare gets to sing A Very Merry Unbirthday, and he also has a little bit of a solo in there. So that will be exciting for Nathaniel. That will be either the end of April or early May that he will be doing that. And then we'll be trying to juggle Isaac's show and Nathaniel's show. But usually I think Isaac's show at his school will be probably over two weekends, and it is quite the distance to go to Windsor and back, but we'll figure it all out. Isaac is prepping for his show. We will be seeing it next weekend, and it will be the following weekend they'll have their final shows, and then he'll be coming home for Christmas after that. So maybe he'll do a takeover on Vlogmas again this year. We will see. And Greg is busy. It's a busy time of year for him. I am super, super busy as well with work and home life, but that is the same for everybody. I know everybody, it's December, everybody is crazy busy, everything is hectic. Breathe, make it through. That's what we will do. Anyway, I think that is all I have to share on Bits and Bobs. I am still trying to figure out, I haven't even started, how I'm going to do my intro for Vlogmas. I have an idea, but I need Nathaniel for that, and he's not home yet. So when he gets home, we'll figure that out. So I am going to say goodbye, and then I'm going to start editing the podcast and then editing Vlogmas. I know I wasn't going to do Vlogmas and the podcast on the same day, because December 1st, I thought one would be enough. But no. I have to do two because, have I mentioned, I think I might be insane. For now, I think I will move on to saying goodbye, and then I will keep myself busy for the rest of the day. I've got lots of knitting, lots of editing. Sometimes I really do take on a little bit too much. Thank you so much for joining me on this final podcast of 2019. I have appreciated that you have spent time with me this year, and I am looking forward to spending time with you in 2020. My gosh, 2020 vision. Crazy to think that we're already at 2020 or coming up to. I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I am wishing me a calm week ahead. I don't know. I will make it through. It will be fun. I really enjoy doing Vlogmas, so I didn't want to not do it because I know it is such a fun thing to do. But I also know that it's a huge undertaking. So thankfully, I have the new computer, which will speed things up considerably. And I'm just going to try and do little snippets from each day, and you never know what December will bring. So this will be the final podcast for this year, and I will return to podcasting in the new year, probably after the second week of January. I'm thinking I'm going to take a little bit of time. Remember, this year's word was balance. I'm still working on next year's word. So I am going to take some time off after finishing Vlogmas and take a couple of weeks, do some personal knitting, which will be just so lovely, catch up on some of that stuff. And then in January, I'll be excited to come back and share all of the lovely things that I am getting up to in my crafting. So for now, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I am wishing you a wonderful holiday season ahead. A Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, Happy New Year, all of those wonderful things and events that we will be celebrating over the next weeks ahead. It's hard to believe how quickly it all goes. And thank you again for joining me in my podcast and spending time with me. I appreciate your time, and I appreciate all of the kind words that you send me throughout the year. So, with that, I am wishing you all of the best in December, and I hope you do join me on Vlogmas, but if you don't, that's okay too. Have the best of holidays ahead. Bye. I have just put the fireplace on. It's beeping in the background, and it's going to go poof. Or not. There we go. Where's my fire? It's cold outside. I want the fireplace on. Does this mean it's time to replace the batteries? There we go. I have fire. I have fire. There. It'll get nice and toasty warm very, very soon.